All right, so this video intro will be a bit longer than normal, but I ask that you watch all of it so that you don't miss out on any important context. So last week, we released a huge update to all versions of Lightroom, and as far as I'm concerned, the biggest improvement comes in the form of non-destructive enhance. In other words, before last week's update, when you applied AI Denoise or Super Resolution to a photo or a group of photos, Lightroom would create separate derivative DNG files for each one. Now, aside from bloating my library with a bunch of seemingly duplicate photos, even though they're technically not duplicates, it also made it difficult for me to keep track of which image had my latest edits. Fortunately, Non-Destructive Enhance solved that by applying Denoise directly to the raw files, removing the need to create derivative DNGs. Now, since the release, we've seen a lot of questions and confusion around how to batch apply Denoise to multiple photos using this new workflow. So in this video, I'm going to show you 7 ways to batch apply Denoise to multiple photos. 2 of them will be in Lightroom Desktop, and the other 5 will be in Lightroom Classic. So feel free to use the chapter time codes to skip to the relevant section for you. Now, another piece of feedback that we've heard is from high volume shooters like the wedding and commercial and event photographers, who are upset about the fact that the non-destructive enhanced batch process locks you from doing other things while it's working. I'd like to explain why that is happening as well. So the flow of this video will be that I'll start by showing you how batch Denoise worked before last week's update. Then I'll move on to why Lightroom now locks focus when using batch Denoise. And then I'll show you how to apply batch Denoise using the non-destructive enhanced workflow in Lightroom Desktop and then Lightroom Classic. Okay, let's dive in. All right, so in the legacy batch Denoise process, I'm selecting multiple raw files that have edits applied. I go to enhance, and then I apply a Denoise amount. And all of this gets baked in as soon as I click on enhance. So now, even though I make edits to the raw files before the DNGs are created, those edits are snapshots. They're basically baked in. And so this is a problem because you might have unknowingly continued editing the original raw file, but when that DNG with the denoise is applied, it had the snapshot of the state of the raw file when you first kind of initiated the enhance. So you have a raw file, it had some edits, and then you kicked off denoise through the enhance dialog. When that starts, it takes a snapshot of the edit state of that image. And so if you went back to that raw file and made edits while the DNG is being created, those edits would not be reflected in the DNG. And again, this kind of creates a problem of keeping track of, wait, which version had the edits? And so that's why I really like that Denoise gets applied directly to the raw file. All right, now I'd like to talk to you about why Lightroom locks you from making other edits when you batch apply Denoise to multiple photos. So you can see here, I have this image with Denoise applied, and I'm just going to copy that. And I'm going to show you this in a minute. This is one of the batch workflows. So I've copied that, and now I'm going to select all 3 of these images, and I'm going to click on Paste Edit Settings. And so you can see now, while this is happening, once this is complete, this is going to start actually applying Denoise, and you can see that I can't do anything to these images. Now, in the previous experience, as I just showed you, you could apply Denoise to multiple photos, and we will create those DNG files, and you can use Lightroom simultaneously. But there is plenty of feedback that you can see where people were just complaining about how long it took to apply Denoise to each of these photos. And so because Denoise is such a resource-intensive task, it makes sense to let that complete before doing anything else. Because by applying Denoise, and I've even done this on my computer, and I've got a pretty powerful computer, it really does tax the computer. It's trying to complete the task as quickly as possible. And so that's one of the reasons. Now, the other reason is that when you apply AI tools to your image, depending on the order that you apply them, it's possible that you can invalidate some of those pixels. And so before, if you did that, like let's say you applied lens blur and then you applied a gen remove stroke, you would see this message that some settings need to be recomputed with an update button, but it wouldn't tell you what. But now we have this AI edit status window that shows you which AI edit tools you've applied, and if any of them have been invalidated, they'll be highlighted in yellow and you can update them. Now with Denoise, That's making edits to every pixel in the image, which is why we have it at the very top of our recommended order of operations, which I'm going to leave here if you want to take a look, if you want to screenshot it. This is our recommended order of operations where, you know, you could go ahead and if you apply these edits in this order, you will never have to update your image. Now imagine if you are applying AI Denoise to a bunch of photos, and then you go to one of them and you apply another AI edit to it that could invalidate pixels. If it's currently applying denoise, that kind of puts it in an awkward state. And so that's why we have to lock Lightroom so that denoise can be completed. And then you're free to make your other AI edits to the image. So again, those are the two reasons why we lock Lightroom for making other edits while you're batch applying denoise. All right, so here we are in Lightroom Desktop, and I'm going to show you the two ways that you can batch apply denoise from one image to multiple images. I already showed you this first one. It's copy and paste. So if I go here and I go back to edit, under detail, you'll see here is denoise as well as super resolution and raw details. I've already applied denoise with a strength of 100. So you can either click copy edit settings, and that'll just copy a bunch of default settings. I prefer clicking on this little gear icon to the right of it, and then I go to select, and then I select modified. And here you can see that only denoise is selected. I'm gonna go ahead and click on copy, and now I'm gonna go back to grid. I'll select the remaining three images here, and you can see there's paste edit settings. There's also keyboard shortcuts, and you can also access it from the file menu at the top here. It's right over there. So let's go ahead and click on paste edit settings. You'll see that Lightroom will begin the process here. And then once this is done, it's gonna apply denoise to all three photos. And as you can see, like I just mentioned, we are prevented from making edits to other images. This is true with all of the batch apply methods in the Lightroom Classic and Lightroom Desktop for these AI tools. Now the second method to batch apply your denoise to multiple images is using presets. So you can see here, again, same image, denoise at 100. I'm gonna open up the presets browser by clicking on this icon over here. And under yours, I'm gonna go ahead and click on plus. Now the way that I generally name my denoise presets is I'll call it denoise and then the strength. So here I had it at 100. And then just like the copy and paste, I'm gonna go ahead and select modified because I only want denoise to be included in the preset here. And I'll just keep it in user presets. And I'm gonna click on save. And so you can see right there, the preset was created, denoise 100 under user presets. Now I'm gonna go ahead and drop to grid. You can see the preset browser is still open. If it's closed, just reopen it. I'm gonna go ahead and select these three images. And then all I need to do is click on that preset that I just created. You'll get a dialog here asking if you wanna apply it. I'm gonna go ahead and click on apply. And then just like before, the same thing happens. Lightroom will process the batch and then it'll start applying denoise to all three photos. All right, now let's move on to Lightroom Classic. And kind of a spoiler alert, I know that Lightroom Classic has five. Two of those five are copy and paste and preset, but I'm going to show you how those work here as well as the other three. So let's start with those first two. I'm going to show you how to apply copy, paste, and presets in Classic. Just like before, I applied denoise already with a strength of 100. Of course, you'll adjust the strength to suit your image. And so to copy and paste, you can see I've got this image selected here. This is the edited photo. I'm going to go to the file menu, go to settings, and right there is copy settings. Now, if you have a bunch of these checkboxes selected, all you need to do is click on check none and then select this one right here for denoise, raw details, and super resolution, and then click on copy. Then what I'll do is drop to grid, select these three images here, then I'll go to photo, develop settings, and select paste settings. And you'll see that Lightroom will start applying the denoise at that 100% strength to all three images. So again, method one, copy paste. Method two is presets. So I'm gonna go ahead here and again, I've got this image at denoise 100. I'm gonna go to the presets panel here, click on this plus and select create preset. I'm making sure that only denoise is selected. So I'm gonna name this denoise 100 and then I'm gonna select create. There you go, you can see that denoise 100 preset was created. Now to apply the preset, I like to drop to grid. I'm going to select these three images. And then over here in the library module under quick develop, I'm going to go to saved presets, click the dropdown, go to user presets, which is where I saved that preset, and then select Denoise 100. And here you can see that Lightroom is applying that denoise preset to all three images. All right, so for batch methods 3, 4, and 5, these are specific to Lightroom Classic. So number 3 is the ability to sync. So to sync, it's pretty straightforward. Again, image has denoise with 100 applied. With the film strip enabled, I'm gonna go ahead and select the active image, and then I'm gonna select the remaining 3 images. Now, you can see here that the primary image, I call it super selected. It's a little bit brighter than the remaining 3 images. And now you can see here that the sync button is active. I'm gonna click it. And this is similar to the copy paste dialog in that you can select which settings you wanna sync from one image to multiple images. And so again, I've got this denoise checkbox enabled. I'll click on synchronize. And there you go. It's synchronizing the edits to the remaining 3 images, even though 4 images are selected. Now, the 4th batch method is kind of a riff off of sync, and it's called auto sync. So just like before, again, I've got my image here with denoise 100. I'm going to select these images, and you'll see that to the left of the sync button, there is a little switch. So I'm going to turn that on. Now, with any images that you have highlighted here in the film strip, watch what happens as soon as I make a change to denoise, for example. I'm just going to bring it to like 95. You can see that Lightroom will automatically start syncing that change to the remaining 3 images. And it'll keep doing that for as long as you have auto sync enabled. So just remember, you might want to turn that off, because if you make another change to denoise, it'll have to reprocess this. All right, so the final batch method in Lightroom Classic is simply using the previous option. So you can see I've got my image with denoise and 100 strength. I'm going to drop to grid, select these images. Then from the file menu, I'm going to go to photo, then to develop settings, and then paste settings from previous. And that will paste that denoise 100 edit to the remaining 3 images. Now, to be sure, there are different ways in Lightroom Classic where you can access the previous button and the sync button. That's just how I use it, so I wanted to show it to you. But I wanted to show you that, yes, you can, in fact, batch apply denoise in Lightroom Desktop and in Lightroom Classic. And so that and the part of this video where I showed why denoise works the way that it does, I really hope that it gives you context and more understanding in that. So with that, I also mentioned that there's plenty that we added to Lightroom Desktop 8.4 last week. It was a huge update. And so I've got this video here if you want to check it out. And of course, if you found this video helpful, a thumbs up is greatly appreciated. It really does help the channel, as does subscribing and clicking on the bell icon to get notified of all future videos. Thanks a lot, everyone.